from around the globe, it's theCUBE with digital coverage of VMworld 2020. Brought to you by VMware and its ecosystem partners.
Hello everyone, welcome to theCUBE's coverage of VMworld 2020. This is a virtual conference, this is theCUBE. I'm John Furrier, your host, with Stu Miniman, Dave Vellante. We are in theCUBE virtual studios in Palo Alto, California, as well as in the Boston area. Stu, Dave, in 2010 was our first VMworld. This is now 2020. What an unpredictable world. In fact, day one summary here for VMworld. This is the theme, a digital foundation for an unpredictable world. What a run. And again, let's do a quick summary of day one. Security, multi-cloud, AI, machine learning, hybrid cloud, modern apps, and networking is the theme. Dave, your reaction to day one.
Well, you know, as usual, VMware has a bunch of announcements at its big show. And I guess I would say that, you know, one of the top jobs of a CEO is TAM expansion. And if you look at these announcements, I mean, Pat Gelsinger said, you got to ride the waves or you're going to be driftwood. And they have done a phenomenal job of translating engineering into new opportunities and delivering customer value around that. And if, and I mean, look at networking, the acquisition of Nicira in the early part of last decade, you know, multi-cloud is a huge opportunity for them. They're clearly a big player in that space. Security with the acquisition of Carbon Black, they've made Kubernetes security acquisitions and others. There's, you know, app defense is in there. So they're going after security. They haven't, you know, made the mark that they want to make yet. You know, modern apps, it's all about, you know, keeping VMware relevant. You know, Project Monterey in hybrid cloud, they're obviously going to be a leader in hybrid cloud. And then the partnership with NVIDIA and machine learning AI, it's kind of a checkbox, but VMware is such a huge install base. Everybody wants to do business with them and everybody wants to do business with NVIDIA. So to me, again, excellent job of TAM expansion and delivering customer value.
And Stu, I want to talk about the VMworld, you know, the part of the experience is being there in person. This year, there is no VMworld, it's virtual. Normally you have the hang space, you have the two cube sets. Here we have a link to theCUBE assets, all of our interviews that we normally do with the two sets. Go check out the main link. But everything is laid out on the webpage. You've got Cloud City, more than 60 solution demos. There's a ton of content, so it's kind of an asynchronous, but it's trying to bring a vibe, but a big gap there for normally, which is a real robust expo floor, hang space, it's all virtual now. They got to ask the experts some other things with Raghu and Joe Beda, among other experts, but a different feel this year, Stu.
Yeah, definitely, John. I mean, this is one of those must-see shows for just a huge ecosystem. We've seen that collision of ecosystems for the last few years. Of course, the epic partnership of VMware and AWS really has dominated a lot of the discussion in the last few years in this ecosystem. So everybody's going to the cloud. We've seen big adoption of the VMware cloud, not just on AWS, but Dave touched on some of the announcements here, like with Tanzu. It's GA with AWS. They're expanding with not only Microsoft Azure, but even Oracle, OCI. And John, one of the things we look at is, you know, who's driving that innovation change? We've seen a big push by VMware to go deep into cloud native, and who's leading that? You know, Joe Beda, who we've known from the early days of Kubernetes, so much of the KubeCon ecosystem is now part of VMware. Greg Lavender, the CTO, he was most recently in industry helping transformation of some large companies, and that's the challenge that VMware has. Going from their dominant position in the data center to live in these cloud environments, we know from a technology standpoint, hey, VM, container, bare metal, you can use whatever makes sense. Build your applications, go faster. So you know, a big change there. And the community, John, it is greatly distributed and highly diverse. Lots of pockets of interesting conversations always. You're right. So, you know, how do we replicate the hallway track? There's some good things we've seen this week, and we're all learning here in the 2020 environment.
Yeah, normally we'd be like yelling over the bands and people trampling to see the concert. John Legend's going to be playing really quickly in the next few minutes. Dave, final word here, because the innovation strategy of VMware has to be on full display in this unpredictable world, multi-cloud, AI, it's crazy right now. Great, huge opportunity, big tailwinds, cloud native with the Snowflake IPO and just ongoing surge. Your thoughts?
Well, I'll just tease some of the conversation we're going to have in our deeper analysis on theCUBE and theCUBE.net is really that hybrid that Stu talked about. And we're seeing VMware Cloud and AWS really rocket. And we're seeing VMware Cloud Foundation and the other foundational elements of VMware Cloud. It's showing up at the data as really having some traction. So that's something that I'm watching very closely.
Guys, thanks so much. I know we're part of a virtual program. I want to thank VMworld for including us in the virtual program. Thanks to the community for all the support over the past 10 years. 2010 was our first Cube at VMworld. Now it's 2020. Thanks for watching.